Thank you so much for inviting me over for dinner, Mrs. Walker. I have enjoyed it so much, and I thought the note was an especially nice touch. And I've enjoyed spending the evening with you and Susan. Where has she gone, anyway?
I don't know. She's playing in her room at 4.
Thank you.
See if she's... Susan!
Perhaps. Delicious.
Oh, you like them?
Homemade?
Yes. No.
Do you mind holding on to this?
I lied. I bought them from the store.
Oh, you got them? And they're all out. Dear.
Susan!
You would have to get more of those. You know, next time to invite Santa over, you must have plenty of milk cookies.
I'm sorry, I'll work on that.
Of course.
Susan, Mr. Kringle wants to talk to you.
Mr. Kringle's here?
Yeah.
Of course.
Could you speak to me in that language you spoke in the store the other day?
Oh, no, Susan, Mr. Kringle's very tired.
No, I am not at all. Come here, Susan.
Oh, just excuse me, I have to call Michelle now.
Just tell me, Susan. Do you have a lot of friends in this building?
Yes, I don't see them very much. The games they play are so childish. Today, they were being animals. They asked me what kind of animal I wanted to be, but I don't want to be an animal. So dumb.
Why didn't you tell them you were a lion or a bear?
Because I'm not a lion, I'm a girl.
The other children weren't animals either. They were just pretending.
And that's what makes the game so silly.
Do you know what imagination is?
That's when you see things that aren't really there.
Yes, but it's more than just that. Imagination is a place you can go to. You've heard of nations like England and Russia and Japan? Well, imagination is a place just like that. Except the wonderful thing about that country is, once you get there, you can do anything you want.
Not anything.
How would you like to fly to Mars and be back in time for supper?
Oh, that wouldn't be possible.
From here, how would you like to be a Statue of Liberty in the morning and fly south at the clock of east in the afternoon? It is as simple as that.
Well, I guess I could try.
Okay, let's start with something simple. How would you like to be a bird soaring through the air?
I wouldn't know how to do that, Mr. Kringle.
Of course you would. Here, stand straight, facing out. Now, arms straight out to the side and wave them up and down like they're wings. Perfect. Now keep flapping. Now turn and soar. Soar, there you go. That is it. You're flying. See that?
I did it, Mr. Kringle. That was fun.
Now tell me, Susan, if you were to actually believe that I was Santa Claus, what would you like me to get you for Christmas?
Can you bring me big presents?
Since we're in the land of imagination, it could be any size.
I want a real house for Mother and me. And a real father to live in it with us.
That is a tall order indeed.
Well, if you're really Santa, you can do it. And if you can't, then you're just a nice man with a white beard, like Mother said.
Now, not everyone can always get their Christmas wish. Now, that doesn't mean that there isn't a Santa Claus. Sometimes, children wish for things they can never use. Like a real locomotive, for example. And sometimes, children wish for baby brothers or sisters, even though their parents wouldn't be able to care for them. And sometimes, a person has to learn something. How to love or behave better before Santa can grant the wish.
But I've wanted a father in the house for such a long time, Mr. Kringle.
And the more you wish for it, the better it'll be when you come. See, if everybody got what he or she wanted right away, life wouldn't be half as much fun. So you see, Susan, there's a lot of reasons why a child wish can't resist.
and the house are really all I want, not toys. Fred!
Hi there, Susan.
Fred, come meet Mr. Pringle.
Hi, I'm Fred Daly. I live in the apartment next door.
Chris Pringle.
Yes, I know.
It's time for bed. Hi, Fred. Have you two met?
Yes, we just introduced ourselves.
Oh, I found you a place to stay. All right, my phone, hang on a minute.
You're looking for a place to stay?
No, I'm actually staying at the zoo.
I've never met anyone who lived at the zoo before.
The zoo is no place to stay, Mr. Pringle. Why don't you stay with me? I've got an extra bed in my apartment. I could use some company.
That is very nice of you, Mr. Galen. Susan, why don't you go tell your mother of our arrangement? I wouldn't want her to worry about me.
Okay, Mr. Pringle. I like the idea of your staying with Fred. He's my friend, and it's right next door.
Good night, Susan.
Good night, Fred.
Good night, Susan.
Good night, Mr. Pringle.
I like the idea too, Mr. Galen.
Call me Fred, please.
Fred.
Now, being so close by would give me a chance to work on Susan's Christmas wish.
No, I'm very fond of that little girl. Oh, I can see that. And what about her mother?
Well, I really like her, but I'm afraid she feels that being neighbors and babysitter with Susan is as close as she wants me to get.
Have you tried inviting her out?
I've tried, but Susan doesn't socialize since her divorce. She concentrates her life on Susan and her career. I don't think she trusts this love anymore.
An old, sad story. But I think it's one that you and I can work on.
Oh, yeah? How do we start?
You just have to keep showing your interest in it and always be aware of her feelings. But most importantly, you must have faith in her.
I've tried all that, and it hasn't done any good so far.
Things will work out. We'll see what happens.
Mr. Pringle, Michelle Hammer is a place for you to stay, and she lives right near the store, so you can get to work easily. I can call you a cab right now and you can go over there.
Actually, I just accepted Mr. Gailey's offer to stay with him.
Mr. Gailey? I see.
I hope it's not in trouble. If you don't mind, I'll go to the zoo and gather my things.
Oh, I'll call you a cab.
Don't worry, I'm sure one will be right outside. Good night.
Good night. Fred, I should tell you about him. I don't suppose you realize he's been diagnosed as suffering from delusions. His doctor asked me to keep an eye on him. He should not be left unsupervised.
Aside from the fact that I think he's quite capable of handling himself, he'll only be next door. Between the two of us, we should have the situation covered.
Well, that's not quite all.
Oh?
The Santa Claus bit, I don't want Susan's influence. I thought I made that very clear to you.
I understand your concerns, Doris, but I like hers. Why not try it out for a couple of days, and if the arrangement doesn't work, then we'll find somewhere else for Chris instead. But in the meantime, I'll take responsibility for it. Trust me, Doris.